Hello students, a very good morning. So students, in last class we were discussing again in hydrostatic Archimedes principle. So Archimedes principle, you have seen that is stating whenever any of the body that is immersed in liquid, then it displaces some of the mass of the liquid, and the mass of liquid is equal to the weight of the body, or mass of the liquid you can say that is displaced. Obviously that mass of the liquid will apply some of the restoring force, and due to that we are getting some loss in the weight of the body. So the loss in the weight of the body is equal to mass displaced by the body. So this is now the Archimedes principle. We have seen its proof also. Now we can define, or we can say state some of the laws based on the Archimedes principle, and that is known as now law of flotation. So let's see now what is the law of flotation. How can we understand whether the body is floating or that will sink there? So here, suppose a body that has density rho, that has volume V, that is immersed completely in a liquid of density sigma. So I think this is now clear. This rho is the density of body. So these are the informations now we have for the system and the liquid. Now two forces, obviously whenever the body will immerse, then two forces will act here. The first force that will act, the true weight W is equal to, you can say mg, or first one force is W is equal to mass into gravity, or the mass of the body can be written as that is density into volume. So volume is what, as our body is now that we are taking, that is obviously some of the shape, then that we have some of the volume here. So as in our discussion already, volume is given, so density into volume into gravity. So this is now the true weight of the body that is acting in downward direction. The second force here that will act on the body whenever it is immersed completely inside the liquid, the second, that is buoyant force or upward thrust. So buoyant force, that is equal to the weight of the or the mass of the liquid that is displaced, or weight of the liquid that is displaced. So weight of liquid, suppose m mass of the liquid is displaced, then weight will be equal to what? This will be obviously equal to rho sigma, mass of liquid. That mass of liquid can be written as density of liquid into volume. So volume is V. On that, due to that V, obviously the mass is displaced, so that's why the volume will be equal. So sigma V into C. This is now the buoyant force that we are getting. We can write here, this is buoyant force, or also it is upward thrust. So total two of the forces on the system that you can see, that is acting, first is true weight of the body that is acting in downward, and the buoyant force that is acting in upward direction. So due to their net effect, obviously the absorbed weight of the body that will be equal to true weight minus this buoyant force. So let's take the difference of that one, and that will be the weight of the body. So what is now the absorbed weight? This is now absorbed weight of the body, and this is equal to difference of these two, because one is acting in upward, downward, second is acting in upward. But as the body is completely inside, then the true weight that should be greater than the buoyant force, and obviously we can take the difference of this one. So simple, let's take the difference of this. Whether we don't know body is floating or not floating, that is going to be sink or whatever, only simple difference of true weight and the buoyant force that we are getting from here. Now obviously we can have the three cases here. We just got this one. By this equation, you can also write the value of W. Value of W is what? That is V rho Z value of W dash is V sigma C, or you can take V V as a common. So rho minus sigma, you can write this is now the absorbed weight of the body. So here first case is what? Case first, three cases can be possible here. First case is when this W, this is equal to, or suppose this W is greater than W dash. First let's see this case. So if W is greater than W dash, it means that the true weight of the body that will be greater than the weight of the liquid that is displaced from there or the buoyant force. So as if this true weight of the body will be greater than, then that time the final force that will act in downward direction, because the true weight W that is acting in downward direction, where the buoyant force W dash, this is acting in upward direction. So if W will be greater than W, that it means that downward force will be greater than upward force. So body will feel a force in downward direction, and due to this force body will sink here. So whenever this condition will occur, then that time the body will sink. So this is our first case here. So if whenever the true weight is greater than the buoyant force, then obviously body will sink in the system, that will not ever flow. So it, or also you can say whenever the absorbed weight that is positive, then that time always this condition of the sinking condition will get. Now case second, what it can be? Case second, if you will see, suppose W is less than WS. In this case, you can see the absorbed weight of the body that will become negative, and also it means that the buoyant force that is acting on the body that is greater than the weight of the body that is acting in downward direction. So it means that a net upward force will act on the body, and due to obviously that upward force, the immersed body will start to go in upward direction, and that will start to just float over the surface. So in this condition, body will start to float over the surface. So body will float. So this is a condition of floating, you can say, of the body. Next one, third one case we have. This is case 3. So case 3 is what? When W is equal to W dash. So in this condition, when W is equal to W dash, we can say, see, absorbed weight of the system that becomes zero. No of the absorbed weight we will feel, and this time the upward buoyant force that will be balanced by the true force. So the body, if it is immersed to the place, then that time as all the forces will be zero on that one, downward force, upward force is zero, no net force is acting, body will be as it is at rest wherever we will just emerge it. So it means that body will float partially, you can say, above the surface or partially down the surface, depending on the condition where we have just immersed it. So means obviously body will be at rest in this condition, and that will be that can be at any place in the liquid whenever we immerse it. Clear, I think. So these are now the law of flotation. State, if you will just summarize the result of this whole discussion and whole cases, then law of flotation, if you will see, this states that a body will float in a liquid if weight of the liquid displaced by the immersed part of the body is at least equal to or greater than the weight of the body, like our case second and third here in this case. Now next topic, let's see here, that is equilibrium of floating bodies. Let's see what is the equilibrium of floating body concept. So in next of the topic, it is equilibrium of floating body. So equilibrium, you know, students, this condition we are observing whenever all the forces acting on the body that will be zero, or simple from the flotation, as you know, body will float when its weight that is less than the buoyant force that is acting on this one, or it is equal to the buoyant force that is acting on this. So a body, you can say, is not in equilibrium even in both of the cases. So body will be in equilibrium only if the resultant of all forces and or couples acting on the body is zero. So this equilibrium we have understood in even system of particles concept, where three kinds of equilibrium even we have discussed. So whenever the resultant force on the system that is zero, then that time body is said to be in equilibrium. Or in rotational concept, whenever the torque acting on the system is zero, or all the couple that is acting on the system, their net is zero, then that time body is said to be in equilibrium. Next, thus we can say the floating body can be in equilibrium if no couple acts on it. It will be so if the line of action of true weight and buoyant force is along the same vertical straight line. So it means that if suppose you have any system, in this system suppose liquid is contained here, in this liquid if any of the body that is floating, but on this body the forces that are acting here, that all forces are zero. And also if you will see the weight of the body, suppose M is the capital M is the mass of the body, so its weight will act in downward. So this is the vertical line that is the action of this weight. So obviously whenever it is immersed, it will displace some of the liquid, and that liquid will also apply some of the buoyant force on this. So the value of buoyant force or the action direction of buoyant force, if that is in the same direction, means if this is the direction of buoyant force, suppose this is buoyant force direction by, so if both will act in the same direction, then that time they will cancel out each other, they will not form any kind of couple. Couple means, you know, whenever two of the forces, their line of actions are different, they are acting at certain direction, even they means they are equal and they are acting at certain direction, then they try to rotate the body. So the what is our confusion here? In third case we have seen when W is equal to W dash, in that case obviously net force acting on the system will be zero, but whenever their line of action will be different, just like this one. Suppose this is the direction of true weight, this is the direction of buoyant force, then that time these two forces, equal and opposite forces, will start to form a couple, and due to that the body will rotate, body will be, you can say, the direction in which you have immersed, the body will turn from it. So if we have to stop that turning also, because of that one, body will become in unstable equilibrium. So in just to make it in stable cases, we need this condition also, the line of action should be same. Whenever line of action will be same, their net will be zero also, they will not form any kind of couple here. So I think this is now clear. And in this case, whenever you can see, if you have to see the center at which you can consider all of the buoyant forces are acting, means if liquid is displaced, all liquid particles will apply the forces from different direction at different parts of the body, but we have to take at the center a point, reference point, where we can assume that all the buoyant forces, their values will be acting, just like the concept of center of mass and gravity. Like center of mass was the point where mass was concentrated, center of gravity where weight of the body is concentrated. Similarly, center of buoyancy is what, where the line of action or center of buoyant force is concentrated. So I think this is now clear. First, why we need the concept of center of buoyancy. So whenever these conditions will be satisfied, only the body will be in equilibrium. So we can just summarize our this whole discussion by some points. So let's see now. Means body will be in equilibrium whenever that is following some of these cases. First case is, a body can float if the weight of the liquid displaced by the immersed part of the body must equal to the weight of the body, or it can be greater than the weight of the body. Only these are two conditions. First two conditions should be fulfilled here, whether these two should be equal or that will should be greater than that. But in equilibrium condition, that should be always equal. that should not be also greater, because in that case that will be in unstable equilibrium case. So that why we need these to be equal. Next one, second case, a body can be in equilibrium if the center of gravity of the body, where the whole of the weight of the body is acting like this point, that is, and the center of buoyancy, where whole of the buoyant force is acting, suppose at this point, that are along the same vertical line. You can see in this figure, they are along the same vertical line. These two conditions will be fulfilled. Now the third condition is, a body will be in stable equilibrium if the center of gravity of body lies vertically below the center of buoyancy, and it will be in unstable equilibrium if center of gravity lies vertically above the center of buoyancy. So if this center of gravity will lie at the point of buoyancy or the at the lower position of buoyancy, then that time body will be in stable condition. But if it will go greater, then that time body will start to be in unstable condition, that will fall or that will fall. So this is now all our laws of flotation. That is, I think, now clear what is the equilibrium or unequilibrium cases in the system. That is also clear. Now students, one part of the hydrostatic that we have covered up to now. So in hydrostatic we have studied a lot of topics up to now. That is like pressure, hydrostatic pressure, atmospheric pressure, Pascal's law, Archimedes' principle, law of flotation, a lot of topics we have discussed. Still in hydrostatic, a very important topic that is left here, and that is the surface tension. So let's see now what is surface tension, and before just understanding surface tension here, let's see some of the some definitions, some terms that we will need whenever we are going to discuss that one. So first topic is here, that is intermolecular forces, the first topic in this case. This is also a case of hydrostatic, intermolecular forces. So as you know by name, it is clear the forces between the molecules of the substances are called intermolecular forces. So this is very easy to understand by the definition already. And if you will see the variation of intermolecular force with interatomic distance, like the two atoms that are separated at some distance, and if we will start to plot the graph of their intermolecular force that will act while we will change the separation between two atoms, then we can see the graph will look like this. Of the graph will look like this one. So this kind of graph, students, you can see now. In this graph, suppose this point, you can see this is the point B, this is point C, this is point O. Suppose this is our point B, this is our point E now. And on this axis we have taken the distance, on this axis we have taken the intermolecular force. So this is now the graph. Now what the graph is showing to us, or what can we predict by using this graph? So graph is telling us when distance is nearly here, this point, at this one distance is nearly 10 inches from some other limit, I can say here. This is near about 3.5 inches from at B point. At this point, this is 5 inches from, and this is obviously 0 inches from. So whenever the ball system is in is at 10 inches from, then that time the force of attraction that is near about 0. And when the distance start to decrease, from this 10 inches from, then up to 5 inches from, you can see the force that starts to increase in negative direction, and it increases up to some point B. So whenever you know the forces, that is force of attraction that is negative, or simple force of interaction that is negative, then that time the force is behaving just like the attractive force. So as in the gravity chapter I have told you about the forces, when force has value negative it is attractive, when it has value positive then it is behaving like the repulsive force. So here it means that the force will, that is obtaining, this is negative. So in this whole of the reason, force is attractive in nature. Means you can say up to 10 angstrom to 5 angstrom, the attractive nature of the atoms that is start to increase. Means whenever you will take away the two atoms, then the two atoms will start to start attraction again. Means they will not let you to take away the atoms easily by separating them. So that's why they will start to show attraction power whenever you will it will reach to the 10 angstrom. And beyond 10 angstrom, if you will take, then that time there is no need to apply or do any of the work to bear the intermolecular force, because at this point it is nearly zero already. Means the atoms starts to allow to take the separation beyond the 10 angstrom. But below the 10 angstrom up to the 5 angstrom, the attraction starts to increase. Then system has tendency up to a limit it can go away, and again it will start to come closer to due to the attraction power that it is applying. But when it reaches to 5 angstrom at a very near distance, then that time its attraction power that starts to decrease. Now they are attracting each other, but that starts to decrease. And when it will reach near about up to 3.5 angstrom, like a very small distance, then its attraction becomes zero. Means up to the limit of 3.5 angstrom to 10 angstrom, the two atoms that are attracting each other, but their attraction varying, that is with distance, you can say from 3.5 to 5 ampere, its attraction starts to, you can say, change, and also again 5 to 10 it start to change now. So simple thing is that if 3 to 5 you will go, attractive force will increase, and again 5 to 10 it starts to decrease, and again 5 to 10 starts to increase there. But whenever you will go beyond the 3.5, mean again if you want to come make closer to two atoms beyond the 3.5, means below 3.5 you have to like it, then that time obviously you can see the graph is showing the positive value of force. Means now our force becomes repulsive at that point. So means we cannot make closer two of the atoms beyond 3.5 angstrom here. So atom has always tendency whenever they are forming molecules, up to a limit they can be attractive, and up to a limit they can be repulsive. So they are showing both kind of nature, attractive and repulsive. Now you can understand by this graph. And also you can see by experiment we have deducted the force of attraction that varies inversely as the 7th power of the intermolecular distance. So force of attraction is what? In this direction we are obtaining force of attraction. In this direction we are obtaining force of repulsion. So this is force of attraction direction. This is force of repulsion. And it has been seen this force of attraction, this is inversely proportional to the 7th power of R here, intermolecular separation. So we can write it one proportionality you will solve, at A can be written as minus of R upon A upon R to the power 7. Minus sign, as you know, that is this is attractive force. Now for the second one, it has been seen the repulsive force that is inversely proportional to the 9th power of the intermolecular separation. Means Fr, this is inversely proportional to 1 upon r power 9, or we can write Fr is equal to 3 upon r to the power 9. So this is now our two of the forces that we can get, and we can understand them. Now you can see the attractive and repulsive forces in the case of molecules that are not obeying inverse square law, like force is not in such a way it is varying with or inverse relationship with R square. So we cannot say these forces are inverse square in nature. So as if these are not inverse square in nature, then that time they are not central forces. They are also not gravitational forces. So they are different types of forces that are acting in the system now. And these are known as now van der Waal forces, or we are also calling them short range forces. So these forces comes into the play whenever we will change intermolecular separation or interatomic separation, only then they will come into the play here. So this is our concept of now intermolecular forces. Now intermolecular forces, you will see that are of two types. One is known as force of adhesion, और वी आर कॉलिंग इट एडहेसिव फोर्स. सेकेंड इज नोन एज फोर्स ऑफ कोहेसन और इट इज नोन एज कोहेसिव फोर्स. सो लेट्स सी व्हाट इज नाउ एडहेसिव फोर्स. एडहेसिव फोर्स इट इज अ फोर्स ऑफ फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन एक्टिंग बिटवीन द मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ डिफरेंट एटम्स एंड वेयर कोहेसिव इज फोर्स एक्टिंग बिटवीन द मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ सेम एटम. सो स्टूडेंट्स आई थिंक टूडे द टॉपिक्स दैट वी हैव डिस्कस दैट आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स एंड दैट इज वेरी क्लियर टू यू वन बाई वन. आई जस्ट मेड द क्लियरेंस ऑफ दिस टॉपिक. सो लेट्स एंड अवर क्लास हियर विद दिस टॉपिक. इन नेक्स्ट क्लास वी विल डिस्कस रेस्ट ऑफ द थिंग्स. थैंक यू.